Shirk is a multimillionaire who could just relax and eat breakfast in bed every single day if he wanted. But what he really wants is to be the first person to perform a dangerous escape while a giant python tries to strangle him.
Bill Shirk wants to prove that he's the number one escape artist in the world. But his lofty aspirations have nearly killed him. Bill Shirk seems to have it all. He's a self-made millionaire who owns a broadcasting empire in Indianapolis, Indiana.
Classic soul and jamming hits. This is the new Kiss 106.7.
Come on, guys.
He's also a happily married man with an 8-year-old daughter who keeps this 55-year-old on the move.
But I have a great life, I have a great wife, I have a great child, and thank you, God.
So why, then, is he willing to risk it all time after time?
I am an egomaniac, and to be an escape artist, you have to be an egomaniac.
After escaping from a straitjacket as a kid in only 24 seconds, Bill was hooked. His success inspired him to read everything he could about the master of escape artistry, Harry Houdini.
I realized Houdini was the greatest promoter in the world. He used escape artistry to promote his magic, to pack his magic house.
Bill quickly figured out that recreating Houdini's escape routines was also a perfect way to promote his radio and TV business.
Are we ready?
Whether that meant hanging from a helicopter 1,800 feet up in the air, or being suspended from burning ropes during halftime at an Indiana Pacers game. Bill even had a song written about him called The Funky 2-Minute Escape.
What a funky 2-Minute Escape!
It's a funky 2-Minute Escape.
Watch out now!
But not all of his escapes have ended in success. Back in 1992, Bill was nearly sent to an early grave after being handcuffed and placed in this plexiglass coffin.
I got a bad feeling about this thing.
It turns out Bill's premonition was justified. First, dirt was piled around the sides of the coffin. Next, 7 tons of cement was poured on top. But the weight was too much. Suddenly, the coffin collapsed. Bill was trapped, totally helpless, beneath thousands of pounds of concrete. Bill's crew frantically attempted to dig him out. Then, after several agonizing minutes, the crowd spotted Bill's hand pushing through the surface.
Hold on.
Moments later, Bill was pulled free and rushed to a waiting ambulance.
I could hear people trying to dig, but hell, I didn't know where I was. Thank God he spared my life on this one, and it'll be a while before I'll do one of these, I'll tell you that.
But Bill is always looking for that next great escape. For Ripley's, he's decided to attempt something he's never done before, escape from 3 straitjackets. On top of that, he'll do it while hanging upside down 25 feet in the air. And one more thing, a python weighing 150 pounds will be coiled around his body at the same time.
A 15-foot Burmese python is just like 15 feet of nothing but solid muscle. It's leaving yourself vulnerable to the snake, basically crushing your larynx.
After Bill has been secured to the crane, the giant python is placed around his torso. As soon as the crane is raised, the snake immediately tightens its grip around Bill's body. It's a defense mechanism that can exert up to 1,000 pounds of pressure. After 1 minute in the air, Bill is struggling but making no progress. 2 minutes pass, and he still hasn't been able to get out of even 1 jacket. Finally, after an agonizing 2.5 minutes, he throws off the first one. Another 30 seconds goes by, and Bill amazes bystanders by escaping from the remaining 2 jackets at the same time. With the massive python pushed to a safe distance from his throat, he's done it. Not only did he get out of all 3 jackets, it only took 3 minutes.
Houdini's spirit was with me tonight, there's no doubt about it.
And Bill hopes that the spirit of Houdini continues to watch over him as he pursues this hobby that frightens everyone but himself.
The most dangerous thing about what I'm doing is thinking that everything's gonna be all right. Being overconfident, that's what scares me.